people access healthcare to make them better. They do not expect healthcare to cause them harm.
The truth is that 8 to 12% of patients getting today to the healthcare facilities will get harm.
Unsafe care has a real human cost. Kevin Murphy died as a result of a series of wrong diagnoses and inappropriate medical care.
Nobody, just nobody at all, just seemed to understand the degree to which he was deteriorating. And there was no sense of urgency. I remember saying to the doctor, do you have any sense of, are you concerned at all about he not being transferred to the university hospital?
Adverse events in healthcare take place in all healthcare settings in all EU member states. There are many different causes of adverse events. It would be unrealistic to expect to eradicate all adverse events in healthcare, but the situation could be much better.
I accept that perfection isn't possible. It is a high risk. It's a high risk endeavour. But we should certainly be striving for excellence.
EU member states are increasingly recognising the need to take steps to address the problem of unsafe care. These measures include efforts to try to tackle healthcare-associated infections, which are among the most serious patient safety challenges in many European member states. One hospital which has taken such steps to tackle healthcare-associated infections is the Franciscus Hospital in Roosendaal, the Netherlands. Staff at the Franciscus Hospital are aware of the threat of healthcare-associated infections. Sufficient staff training and specific procedures have been put into place to reduce the risks to a minimum.
Short operating times are very important in preventing post-operative wound infections, but there are also many, well, general measurements to be taken, such as early mobilization of patients, fast removal of the urinary catheter, and careful wound dressing, careful wound handling in general.
I think it's really important that you know upfront that there is a serious chance of an infection, and that the nurses tell you about it, why they treat it like they do, and if the treatment must be handled with utmost care.
So whilst there are many good examples of action to improve patient safety in all EU member states, the EU can also play an important role in supporting member states in their efforts to tackle adverse events in healthcare.
The Commission decided to focus on this because we would like to create the environment for change and help member states and organizations, professionals to share best practices how to reduce number of those serious problems to the patients.
This is why the European Commission chose to make patient safety one of its priorities in 2008.
The Commission is thus developing a Commission communication and a proposal for a Council recommendation on patient safety and quality of health services, including the prevention and control of healthcare-associated infections, in order to add EU-level value to member states' efforts to improve safety in their healthcare systems. If member states adopt the proposals, this will signal a strong political commitment to tackling patient safety. This will also lead to a stronger patient safety culture in the member states. The proposal for a council recommendation will suggest action for member states, either individually or collectively, and for the Commission. The recommendations, if followed, will help to reduce mortality and morbidity of EU citizens receiving healthcare.